The Lithuanian-born businessman Joe Kagan, formerly Juozapas Kaganas, was having KGB officials as house guests. Churchill may or may not have known that in fact Wilson had been warned by MI5 about Kagan's connections as early as 1968, and that, as his principal private secretary, Robert Armstrong, later revealed, Wilson had been interviewed at his own request by MI5 about the matter in 1972, when it emerged that at least one of Kagan's associates was among the KGB agents excluded from Britain under Operation Foot. Wilson asked the security service not to speak to Kagan directly, but agreed to warn him personally about his contacts. In a pointed note, lest anyone thought him naive, Wilson added, "For the record, I always assume the Russians I speak to may be connected to the KGB." An investigation into Kagan found that the KGB had been trying to use him as an agent of influence, but effectively cleared him of being a conscious agent himself. Given the prevailing sensitivities of the time, it would be reasonable to assume that, even for appearance's sake, Wilson might have tried to distance himself from Kagan and his like. In fact, the reverse was true. Wilson continued, almost defiantly, to associate with controversial business leaders with Eastern Bloc connections, such as Kagan and the industrialist Rudi Sternberg, proudly wearing Gannex raincoats from Kagan's West Yorkshire factory while puffing away on his pipe. Sternberg was elevated to the Lords in 1975. Kagan followed in Wilson's resignation honours the following year, as part of what became known as the Lavender List, as it was alleged to have been handwritten by Marcia Williams on her lavender-coloured notepaper, though she has always denied having any influence on its content. Bernard Donoghue was even more sceptical of such businessmen than the investigators who begrudgingly cleared them. "There's no doubt in my mind that Kagan and Sternberg were KGB agents," he told me. Sections of the press in 1974 and 1975 were quite blasé when it came to talking about Wilson as a would-be traitor.